Hi. Amy, what are you doing with all those products in your arms?
Well, let me tell you, I am at a bit of a loss. So, I have had blue hair for a while now, and anyone who colours their hair fun colours knows that you get sick of the same colour. Brown is fine, you won't really get sick of brown, it's just your easy go-to when it's your root colour. But I have always dyed the bottoms of my hair like this so that if I hate it or something goes wrong, I can just cut it off. But my hair is already really short and it's springy, so that I know if I were to cut off this much blue, I wouldn't have much left to work with. So I am going to ruin my hair potentially for the sake of this experiment. So I want to get the blue hair out. I want it to be blonde again. I know I'm dreaming. It's already really faded. I use Paintbox. Manic Panic, in my opinion, is really well pigmented, but myself and another person that I know that has used blue Manic Panic has found that it can come off on your sheets and your pillows and stuff, and whatever it touches, it's there to the end of time. My experience with this, used this when I was a little emo kid, dyeing my hair every day, and it's fine. So my friend at work said use, y'all are gonna hate me for this, dishwashing liquid. So I did, and this is what we've gotten. And when it's summer and you can just go for a swim in a pool where there's chlorine, sometimes I'm not taking credit for that in case something goes wrong, but in my experience, when you go swimming in a pool, all of your colored hair somehow is just out. Can we not play pig right now? Or in the ocean and you're just, you know, submerged, and somehow that helps get color out as well. I had a bath and that helped get a lot of it out as well, but I just used shampoo and conditioner. So I've had a couple of looks at what we can do online. There was one that was like, this is my friend's one, you mix dishwashing soap, developer, 10 bowl developer, purple shampoo, and don't hate me, I can't remember. There was a fourth thing. And that is something that you just like kind of lightly bleach it out. So I have bought developer, and that's going to be like the last thing that I try, I think, because I feel like we can try some other options first. Everyone online says Head and Shoulders. I got apple flavor because hell yeah, let's give it a sniff. I also bought this online. So I am very nervous to use this. I don't even know if I will. So like if I go and wash my hair with this and it comes out, I'm not gonna go use this, you know, but I'm also not liking my chances of just being able to shampoo it out after this long. It's getting there, it used to be really dark. So this is colorless hair color remover, and I realize now that it says removes black, brown, and red buildup. This is none of those colors. But I will say that one of the good things about this is it doesn't have any bleach or ammonia in it, and the way that it pulls the color out of your follicles in your hair is better than when you bleach it, because when you bleach it, it closes the follicles up. So let's say I have blue hair and I bleach it and it goes blonde again, we hope, but because I've used the bleach, if a hairdresser were to bleach it again or dye it, the follicles would open back up and the hair would go blue again. It doesn't matter how long later. So obviously we just want to get it out, but again, tell me that doesn't look edited. This is a lie, but we might see how we go. I also bought a hair mask because I have poor impulse control. And that's it. So I'm going to go wash my hair with this and we will see if it makes much of a difference. Okay, so I think I've lied to you guys and I've given it like 3 or 4 days of washing, but still blue. So my next step is going to be this color remover, which again, it says like black, brown, red build up, and you know, we got the opposite, we got blue. But I'm thinking, because I don't want to ruin all of my hair, I'll just like separate it and do like a little tiny bit and we'll see what happens there, because I don't, this is a bit scary. And we also have to pick a different t-shirt to sacrifice to the hair dye gods. Okay, so I just bought it from the box color section of Woolies.
what it looks like inside. Colorless remover A, colorless remover B, C.
I'm realizing now that like all of the blue at the back is actually, there's not much of it. Should I get a brighter bit? Got too much hair. All right, that looks so strange.
This is bringing back a lot of memories from when I was 16.
Oh my god, how long is this gonna take? Now we shake vigorously.
Oh, one time I wasn't ready to throw away one of these dye things from like a packet box, and I left it sealed, shaken up, like made, in the cabinet in my dad's bathroom. And one day we just hear this like massive bang, and we're like, what the fuck was that? Go to the bathroom. This thing that I had in there full of hair dye had exploded. I think it was just like brown. It wasn't bleach or anything, but I guess that's what happens. So I'm hoping that if I don't like use all of this and I put it aside, cause we have to let it wait for 45 minutes. I'm hoping that it, doesn't explode. Okay. Oh, we got that little bubble. Oh my god, I got it on the bloody...
I got it on the carpet.
Sorry, Max. Well, all that for just that, I know. But now I get to wait for 45 minutes and you guys get to just wait 30 seconds.
It smells really bad.
Okay, it's been 45 minutes. It doesn't look lighter yet, but we will go rinse and dry and have a look. So rather than just like a hair color remover, I would say this is more of a hair lightener, because this is definitely brighter than when we started with, but it also kind of just looks like it's been made a bit green compared to the rest of it. Or maybe I'm just imagining things. I don't think it really did anything except made my hair smell bad. Yeah, honestly, not much of a difference in color. I guess we're going to plan C, and I don't mean like colorless C. Okay, so now we're up to the last resort and we've got to pull out the scary stuff. But we're gonna do a bleach bath. So that is a combination of bleach powder, a small volume developer, but I've got 20. I'm pretty sure you should probably do it with 10, but we'll just monitor it. Shampoo and water, and it's gonna make like kind of a soupy consistency, but I'm just gonna go straighten my hair a little bit so that I can see the lines better, because, you know, it's a bit hard. Okay, so I'm gonna go into the bathroom now. I'm gonna mix up my bleach and you're going to judge me because I don't have a little bowl and a brush that the hairdressers use. So I'm gonna be using my hands and gloves. Don't worry, I'm not that silly. And one more thing that I just wanted to point out is underneath all of here, you guys probably don't really care about this, but I am going to include it anyway. Under here, we've got one, two, and there's a third one of these little mullet bits, because when I first dyed my hair blue, this was all like that short. So I was like, I don't want to dye like my little mullet blue and have it like grow out weird. So now is the time for bleaching these bits, I guess. I think I will bleach them separately with like an actual bleach concentration rather than a bleach bath. When I do it, I separate these into like little pigtails and I'll tie it up. This is what I did when I dyed it the first time, so I guess I'm just gonna do this with the bleach. But I would get like my pigtail and I'll get my bleach on my hand and just kind of, and that was what I did here and across here with all the blue, which turned out great, to be honest. I think any hairdresser will be looking at me and being like, ooh, I don't know about that. But I'm probably just gonna do that again, and I really hope this does something. Otherwise, I guess I'm just gonna have blue hair forever.
Thank you.
results were not ideal. We're still blue, but in the light, this one's a little bit still wet, it's significantly lighter. Maybe I'll give it another round. Why not?
Well, it's definitely not blonde, but yeah, it's lighter than it was. I could probably put another color over this. And I bleached my little mullet bits at the back, so I'll definitely be putting a color over that. That turned out fine. But the question, can I get blue hair dye out? No. No, I cannot. So I ended up putting another color over it because, of course, I'm not going to like go to work or leave the house with like light green, gray, gross bits. But this is actually red. So underneath in the mullet region, it's like actually red versus here, which is purple. So don't know if I love it. Definitely wasn't what I was going for. Purple is actually like my least favorite color. So I ended up just washing it out and just straight up 30 volt bleaching the ends again. And I've trimmed all of the gross little dead bits and deep conditioned it. I wanted to go neon yellow, but like we saw how that ended out. That was never gonna happen. If I put yellow on top of what this was, it was just straight up going to be green, and green was not what we were going for. So, I hope you enjoyed this hair tour with me. I will one day get neon yellow, hopefully, but today is not that day. Honestly, it could have turned out so much worse. Like, this is still fine.